Welcome students in our today's online English class. Today we are going to study the 7th chapter of first flight book for the students of class 10. The name of the chapter is Glimpses of India. Today we will study its second part, Kurum, written by Lokesh Abrol. So the second part is Kurg. This part is a pen portrait of Kurg, which is a coffee growing area. It is also famous for its rainforests and spices. So let us begin the chapter. Midway between Mysore and the coastal town of Mangalore sits a piece of heaven that must have drifted from the kingdom of God. This land of rolling hills is inhabited by a proud race of martial men, beautiful women and wild creatures. Kurg or Kudagu is the smallest district of Karnataka. It lies midway between Mysore and coastal town of Mangalore. It is like heaven on earth. Drifted means separated. It seems that the place is drifted or separated from the kingdom of God. It is a land of rolling stones that is inhabited by proud race of martial men, means having to do with war or brave men. Okay, so the place is inhabited by martial men, beautiful women and wild creatures. Let's see next paragraph. Kurg or Kudagu, the smallest district of Karnataka, is home to evergreen forests, spices and coffee plantations. Evergreen rainforest cover 30% of this district. During the monsoon, it pours enough to keep many visitors away. The season of joy commences from September and continues till March. The place Kurg or Kodagu is the smallest district of Karnataka. Is home of evergreen forest, spices and coffee plantations. These evergreen forests cover 30% of this district. And during monsoon season, there is plenty of rain so that visitors keep away from this place. So, the best season to visit Kurg starts in September and continues up to March. The weather is perfect with some showers thrown in for good measure. The air breathes of invigorating coffee. Coffee estates and colonial bungalows stand tucked under tree canopies in prime corner. So here, invigorating means make feel someone healthy. Tucked means hidden. The weather is pleasant during the month of September up to March. And the smell of coffee is all around. It's scattered all around and it seems pleasant when we visit the place. Many coffee estates and colonial bungalows are scattered around the forest. The fiercely independent people of Kurg are possibly of Greek or Arabic descent. As one story goes, a part of Alexander's army moved south along the coast and settled here when return became impractical. These people married among us the locals and their culture is apparent in the martial traditions, marriage and religious rites, which are distinct from the Hindu mainstream. So, it is considered that the people of Kurg are possibly descendant of Greeks and Arabs. Fiercely means powerfully, decent means origin. It is believed that Alexander's army moved south along the coast and settled here when return became impossible for them. These people married among the locals and their culture can be witnessed by their martial tradition, marriage and religious rites, which is very different from the Hindus mainstream. The theory of Arab origin draws support from the long black coat with an embroidered waist belt worn by the Kodavus, known as kufia. It resembles the kufia worn by the Arab and the Kurds. The other story says that the people of Kurg are possibly descendant of Arabs. The Kodavus, resident of Kurg, wear a long black coat with an embroidered waist belt worn by them, which is known as kufia. It resembles kufia worn by the Arab and the Kurds. Kurgi homes have a tradition of hospitality, and they are more than willing to recount numerous tales of valor related to their sons and fathers. The Kurg regiment is one of the most decorated in the Indian Army, and the first chief of the Indian Army, General Kariyappa, was a Kurgi. Even now, Kodavus are the only people in India permitted to carry firearms without a license. Kurgi or Kodavus are known for their hospitality. There are many tales of their bravery. Numerous tales of valor means numerous stories of courage. There are many stories related to the people of Kurg of their bravery. The Kurg regiment is one of the most decorated regiment in the Indian Army. The first chief of Indian Army, General Kariyappa, was a Kurgi. Kodavus are the only people in India permitted to carry firearms without a license. The river Kaveri obtains its water from the hills and forests of Kurg. Mahaseer, a large water fish, abounds in these waters. Kingfisher dive for their catch, while squirrels and langurs drop partially eaten fruit for the mischief of enjoying splash and the ripple effect in the clear water. Elephants enjoy being bathed and scrubbed in the river by their mahavats. The river Kaveri originates in the hills of Kurg. In the water of river, a large freshwater fish can be found in abundance. Means in Kaveri river, we can see plenty of mahaseer fish. Kingfisher dive in the river for fish. Other animals found here are squirrels, langurs, etc. Elephants enjoy being scrubbed in the river by their mahavats. The most laid-back individuals become converts to the life of high-energy adventure with river rafting, canoeing, rappelling, rock climbing, and mountain biking. Numerous walking trails in this region are a favorite with trekkers. Kurg offers many adventurous activities such as river rafting, canoeing, rappelling, rock climbing, and mountain climbing, biking, and trekking. Birds, bees, and butterflies are there to give you company. Macaws, Malabar squirrels, langurs, and slender loris keep a watchful eye from the tree canopy. I do, however, prefer to step aside for wild elephants. We can see variety of species there, like birds, bees, butterflies, macaws, malabar squirrels, langurs and elephants. All of them attracts our attention. The climb to the Brahmagiri Hills brings you into a panoramic view of the entire misty landscape of Kurg. A walk across the rope bridge leads to the 64-acre island of Nasargadma, running into Buddhist monks from India's largest Tibetan settlement at nearby Bailukupi is a bonus. The monks in red ochre and yellow robes are amongst the many surprises that wait to be discovered by visitors searching for the heart and soul of India right here in Kurg. Panoramic view means a view of a wide area of land. One can have a panoramic view of the entire Kurg by climbing the Brahmagiri Hills. Other interesting places are the Nisargadma and the largest Tibetan settlement, Bailukupi. This settlement is inhabited by monks in red and ochre and yellow robes. There are many surprises in this place to be discovered by visitors searching for the heart and soul of India. You can find all the beautiful and interesting things right here in Kurg. Kurg can be reached by road and by rail. If one prefers to go by air, then the nearest airports are Bangalore and Mangalore. So that's all for the day. Thank you so much.